So guys, good morning
everyone.
I was trying to show you some natural biomolecules and of course some synthetic molecules which contains the hydroxy group alcohols, which are basically alcohols. This is a compound. And this is chloramphenicol, which was a first-generation antibiotic used for treating typhoid fever. It has two hydroxy groups, two. And this has two double bonds, not conjugated, and OH group. And that is geraniol. That is one of the chemicals present in clove oil. Geraniums. Clove, I'll show you later. That is used as perfumes in flower rose. You get one of the geraniums, and this you can name them. I will send you. You can name them. You're quite proficient in naming compounds. But again, since we are studying chapter by chapter, you also have, now this is the structure of cholesterol. So many rings. I just wanted to show you. So many rings. And the alcoholic group is there. And this is cholecalciferol, vitamin D3, that also contains the alcoholic OH group. And so many other rings, not as many rings as cholesterol. But there are three rings and so many conjugated double bonds. Now this is capsaicin containing, of course, phenolic. This is not alcohol. This is phenol. We have not yet started. We will do separately, not together. And this is dopamine, a neurotransmitter, which is a phenolic compound. We shall be studying that later. But I would like to you to now I can share my teach you. Okay, I remember now. Now I had a something. Can you name this compound? Just try to name this a particular. We have to say this demands the adjective R or S, because this is a chiral center. Alcohol, no doubt, but it has a chiral center. And this has two chiral centers, this one and this one. You have to say, according to nomenclature, three, what is the configuration at three? 3R or 3S? And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And what is the configuration of 6? So also there are two chiral centers. So these two, three you will do later. But can you name this alcohol? This is very simple. I have also trained you how to, assign the configuration from even the plying age formula. Obviously, the hydrogen which is missing out there is above the plane. Two are lying on the plane. Chlorine is lying below the plane. And definitely, matter. I was just saying, what is the name of this compound? I asked you here. Raise your hands, please. Anyone who has completed, am I audible to you? So, anyone, this compound? Khan Saab. Yes, Khan Saab. बोलिए
सर 2R 3 फिनाइल 2 सर थ्री आर
थ्री
सॉरी टू सर टू आर थ्री फिनाइल टू क्लोरो प्रोपन वन ऑल.
ओके एक मिनट जस्ट अ मिनट यू वर सेइंग इट इज हाँ साहब आप क्या बोल रहे थे व्हाट इज थ्री आर
सर सर टू एस
वन दिस इज वन टू टू एस नाउ यू हैव चेंज ओके
टू एस थ्री फिनाइल
वन टू थ्री फिनाइल यस दिस इज
क्लोरो टू क्लोरो
सो इट शुड बी टू क्लोरो फर्स्ट इजंट इट
यस सर टू क्लोरो थ्री फिनाइल
थ्री फिनाइल
propan one all
propan one all now see all of you have a look very carefully has his prediction come true or not see chlorine is lying below the plane you may not we may not have to convert it into Fischer formula that means hydrogen is lying above the plane you have to apply the golden rule opposite rule So number one group is the side containing OH. Carbon is directly bonded to O. This carbon is carbon. So this hydroxymethyl is number one group, senior most group, followed by chlorine is the number one group. Then hydroxymethyl is number two. Then phenyl is and this is benzyl is number three, right? So one to two to three, my eye is rotating anticlockwise. And this is golden rule. This is R, my dear Khansa. ठीक है ना? आप you should not have muted yourself as long as this discussion is not over. Khansa, फिर एक बार हाथ उठाइए. मैं आपको फिर एक बार unmute करूं. तो are you convinced?
Yes, sir.
The first proposal was correct. This is wrong because. Even at the later time you try by converting it to this flying waves formula convert it to the what the Fischer formula the way I taught you then also you will find the same thing 1 to 2 to 3 anticlockwise and hydrogen is lying above the plane so it is not s it is r everything else is correct how many of you have done r can you raise your hands Adhyasa Swami Abhilas like you can see that participant list is at your disposal. So let us now, without wasting more time, I would not give any more revision problems. We have done so many. Preparation methods of alcohols like alkyl halides. I would like to tell you that if it is 1 degree alcohol, 1 degree halide, then it is preferably substituted with aqueous cavitch, strong base aqueous cavitch, OH minus. But if it is 3 degree, then hydrolysis will make SN1 route. And will produce. This is SN1 root for 3 degree, and for 1 degree it is SN2 root to give the substitution. Same alcohol, but for 1 degree we can't take water. It will be extremely slow. As a base, as a nucleophile, everything it is weak. So extremely slow, almost reaction will not happen. For 1 degree we have to take a strong base OH minus. And we have also seen hydrolysis of ester, both acidic and alkaline. We have seen that. And this is very important, reduction of aldehydes and ketones, carboxylic acids and esters. We have seen that the best choice is lithium aluminum hydride followed by even water. Usually we don't write water. Or if you add some dilute acid also will help. In many books you will find H3O plus, doesn't matter. But theoretically and also practically, water is a stronger base, stronger acid. Then, in this reaction, alkoxide ion plus water will give you alcohol. So alcohol is a weaker base than water. So the reaction is possible, but they are very close. Therefore, usually some acid solves better purpose. But you know, you can also write water. In you, that reduces both carboxylic acid and ester together, all four. And if it is sodium alcohol and it is ester, this is called Bobelt-Blanc reduction. Sodium borohydride is another substitute. It's not meant for carboxylic acid and ester. You know, the in situ nucleophile that both the sisters, La, lithium aluminum hydride and sodium borohydride, produce is the hydride ion. It's not a direct hydride ion. A direct hydride ion is a very hard base, and hence the nucleophilicity is very, very small. That's the beauty. Now I have shown you the mechanism, whether it is lithium aluminum hydride. This is the tetrahydride aluminate ion. This one is the complex AlH4-. Or if it is borohydride, it is replaced by B. Now the hydride ion is not free here. It is providing hydride ion in the reaction. Therefore, the reaction proceeds very fine, very well. We are not taking sodium hydride or lithium hydride, where hydride ion is the original nucleophile, whose nucleophilicity is very, very poor, although it's a very, very strong base. In fact, the strongest base in the hierarchy. But it is the poorest nucleophile because it is very hard. It's so small in size, you know, so hard that the, you know, lone pair has no mood to attack onto the electrophilic center. But here, borohydride, since boron-hydrogen bond is more covalent in nature, so the hydride ion, you know, this bond breaking is less probable than lithium aluminum hydride. So La solves all purpose, including ester and carboxylic acids. But lithium borohydride, its younger sister, cannot reduce the two, that means carboxylic acid and ester, because you know this bond doesn't break so efficiently in borohydride as in case of aluminum hydride, having some polar character, more polar character. So the hydrolytic cleavage becomes facilitated. Now then, you know, this, why water is required in the second step? It is because the product formed is not the final alcohol, the neutral alcohol. It is alkoxide ion. So acidification is needed. Since water is a stronger base than alcohol, so this displacement is possible. Any acid-base reaction, a stronger acid displaces a weaker acid, or a stronger base replaces a weaker base. So in whichever way you want to rationalize, you can understand that. So we had a conclusion that a primary alcohol is produced from aldehyde, ketone produces secondary alcohol, carboxylic acids produces primary alcohol, and ester produces primary alcohol from the carboxyl part, and another alcohol which depends on the nature of R. It can be primary, secondary, or tertiary depending on the nature of R. I would have given some SAQs today, but since we had some discussion on examination, yesterday's examination, and other things cropped up, so next class, means tomorrow, we'll have a lot of things. Maybe I can give you in our group ID some questions, some SAQs for you to practice. Right? Uh, First, let us talk, take up the next method. What is the point? The point is, point number X. You write down the point. Let me first cover up the important methods first. Point number X, for example, you give the point number 4 or 5 or 6 from Grignard reagent. Alcohols can be prepared from Grignard reagents very, very efficiently, very, very efficiently. Now, can you tell me one more thing I would like to ask you? Yes. This is the same Klein book I was referring while I was having a program on resonance. And many of you have had attended that. You know, that is a very good book for beginners, I mean plus two level. So yes, this one. Can you tell me? No, not this one. No. Reducing agents. Yes. One more thing I didn't tell you is just go back to your reduction of aldehydes, ketones, carboxylic acids, and esters. To that point, you please visit, revisit, and right at the end, catalytic reduction is not applicable when there is a C double bond C, while C double bond C, while La or sodium borohydride do not affect C double bond C, particularly when they are unconjugated. Say, for example, supposing we have two routes, you take hydrogen palladium heat and we take La followed by water. These are the two steps. You don't write together, because immediately when you add water to La, immediately hydride and hydrogen ion from water, they will produce hydrogen gas. There will be nothing left. So these are the two successive steps. Now in La sodium borohydride, this double bond is unaffected. It remains as such. And only the aldehyde part is converted to primary alcohol. We know that aldehyde is converted to primary alcohol. But here, both of them, I'm writing here, both the double bond will be saturated. So all these minor details you must know. Although I am very sad to tell that most of you are not having the setup, mind setup to go to that level, to revise every time. For example, the knowledge of the acid-base theory, which we did so extensively in our ionic equilibrium program, taking so many organic examples in our discussion. Knee is needed every now and then. So you will not revise that unfortunately. So to the level which you are supposed to visit, go, will be missing out. Although I will be disseminating my experience. Otherwise, I told you that my food will not be digested. But it's very difficult for you to play with all these things. And now, Aro, I'm very sad to tell you that what was your interest? You know, you must introspect yourself in a very objective way. Never overestimate nor underestimate. So if you handle a very sophisticated book, high book, and your teacher will just tell you, you understand, because the infrastructure is being built. But to assimilate that and to reproduce in the examination is a different job altogether, for which a serious attempt, a hard work, hard effort is needed. So which possibly in this time when you are mixed with so many coachings and all that, and the upbringing has been so poor, so it's very difficult. I'm watching for the last several years. It's not your fault at all. But greed is such a terrible thing that it cripples both a teacher and taught, mostly the teacher. I am not able to resist, you know, the temptation of sharing everything that I want to share. So I cannot sermonize because I am not able to control. So it's impossible for you to resist the greed of, you know, handling a hi-fi book and ultimately landing in a catastrophic situation. Now, in this case, you get all. This double bond is saturated and this aldehyde is converted to secondary alcohol. So that part I was missing. So you have written that. Let us come back to our original work. Grignard reagent, that is a very important point. This one. Now, GR reacts with formaldehyde followed by hydrolysis, I mean water or H3O plus second, to give you 1 degree alcohol. I will tell you how. GR reacts with any other aldehyde followed by hydrolysis or H3O plus to give you 2 degree alcohol, and GR reacts with ketone to give you a 3 degree alcohol. The most convenient method of getting alcohol from Grignard reagent. So will I go to the next phase, Miss Shubham, Sambit Sahu, and AK, you did not submit your test paper. You told you woke up late, so I gave you the question paper, but of no use. Okay, you solve it and send it to me. Rajat is missing today. Rajat, are you here? You are not there for... Okay. Now see. Grignard reagent is this. Just see. Don't write. You know, R part is having negative charge, partial negative charge. In fact, that will be converted to a carbanion. It has a strong minus delta character, being a non-metal, carbon and magnesium is a metal. So this part has a strong plus delta character. So ultimately it will be released as R minus when it will attack. And you know, this pi bond will be polarized, and what will happen? It will produce this. I am writing the same skeleton, O minus and then MgX plus. And the mechanism, detailed mechanism, we shall be doing in our aldehydes and ketones program after this, that is nucleophilic addition. This R, which was minus delta, will become R minus, completely a carbanion to attack. And then pi bond will be polarized. And immediately O minus will have a friend, MgX plus. This will be completely plus. And then you need to, this is alkoxide ion, you have to either add water or H3O plus. In some books, you find water. In some other books, you will find H3O plus. Both are equally correct. Now, so what happens if you write in a straight manner, you will find it is nothing other than 1 degree alcohol plus Mg OH X, because out of HOH, H plus has joined here, and H plus has joined here and OH minus has joined here, so that you get this and a neutral alcohol, that is 1 degree alcohol. Over. So formaldehyde is required. If you want a 1 degree alcohol, you can take any Grignard reagent. Grignard reagent has no restriction in the structure of R. But the restriction is you have to take formaldehyde. Add in the first step to get the alkoxide ion, then add acidic substance like water or any other dilute sulfuric acid to get neutral alcohol. That will be volatilized out, distilled out. This will remain as the residue. And in the same manner, if you go for any other aldehyde, say R-CHO, not formaldehyde. One hydrogen is there, but the other hydrogen is replaced by an alkyl group. In that case, the same addition, what we were doing, will produce R-dash will be joining. I'm sorry. This is R dash, this is R. R will be joining to the carbonyl carbon. The same way we did for formaldehyde, the skeleton of formaldehyde is replaced by the skeleton of any other aldehyde. And then this R is joining here the carbonyl carbon. Pi bond is polarized and you are getting this. Then subsequent hydrolysis or H3O plus, anyone, will produce a 2 degree alcohol. Plus the unwanted product, this one you can write down. It's not required in a roadmap problem or conversion or something like that. But since it is your class notes, you write all the other products. This is a 2 degree alcohol, R, R dash and CH. There is one hydrogen. Right? So, similarly, if you take a ketone, is it not over? Oh, I didn't see. Write down. I know the nerves, the veins of my students, the nerves, the veins. So I will rectify myself whenever the need be. So if you take a ketone instead of an aldehyde or formaldehyde, you take a ketone, obviously our intuition says that the same kind of nucleophilic addition will produce and this on hydrolysis with water will produce a 3-degree alcohol plus the same unwanted MgOHX. So this is a 3-degree alcohol. So we can pick up some examples. So exactly 1 hour more. So we shall be moving without any distraction to make a sizable progress. A convincing progress we have to make. This is a very vast chapter, but maximum one more class will be required. I mean, tomorrow we will complete alcohols for sure. Then phenol is also equally big. And then ethers is in between. Now over, okay. Now SAQs on that. So what will happen if acetaldehyde, you know, after some time you develop such an intuition that you write down the product in one go without, you know, taking in a mechanism route that I was explaining, aromark route. You can just write down, but not now. Supposing we add, and a random manner I am giving you, and then followed by water. You write in the way I explained to you in aromar, giving aromar that the alkyl group will be bonded to the carbonyl carbon, the pi bond will be polarized, and then MgBr will be linked to that O minus MgBr plus, then hydrolysis of that alkoxide ion will produce the corresponding alcohol. Tell me what kind of alcohol will be produced. Chinmay, Miss Bhol, I am so happy that you have made some progress at least. You were found at the bottom of the mark list. Now you are found in between. That's a good progress, and keep it up. Don't be complacent. Your standard is much higher. You have to elevate yourself with a conviction. Sandhya. Chinmay, what happened? You removed your hand? AK. Arpita. Without wasting time, have a look. On this you may not write in this mode, you may write like this, the way I told you, so that just copy the same mode. This time X is specific, bromide, write that, and ethyl is joined now to the carbonyl carbon and everything else remains the same. Then when you hydrolyze that, then you straighten the chain, write in a systematic manner so that it will be CH3CHOH, right? Make it CHOH, then CH2, then straighten this chain. Look it more impressive, not zigzag structure. So write like this. So this is butane to all. How many of you have done butane to all? Siv, I'm so happy after a long break. We have completed 3 chapters. Then I give you another example. Same logic. Then followed by, this time I switched the placement of Grignard reagent and the aldehyde, this time is formaldehyde. So the moment you are getting formaldehyde, that will be converted to CH2OH. That formaldehyde part will be converted to CH2OH. You know, this part will be joining here. And this formaldehyde part will be converted to the CH2OH group. So once you know that, then in one go, you can write without entering into the mechanistic way to waste time. Whenever you are asked a question on mechanism, you will be doing that. And we are not studying it in a regular basis, because that will come in our aldehydes and ketones chapter. And what I wanted you, after you bring mastery, simply, Monali, you just write whatever R is there, it just add CH2OH, that's it. R will be just joined with CH2OH, 1 degree alcohol. By that, you avoid steps. And of course, you know, next time in my roadmap problem, I will write like this, and above arrow mark, this followed by water. Supposing grignard reagent, I will give it here. Then aldehyde, I will be giving here, or ketone. Then B2 water. Then you have to write down the product in one go. There is no time to write the steps. This is isobutyl alcohol. And many of the newcomers must have faced difficulties. I told you, I gave you a tip before the examination, that you must converse yourself with isobutyl, secbutyl, tert-butyl, isopropyl, this, particularly these four, and make out immediately what is what. So this is iso. And then I'll give you another ketone. Say I give you acetone reacting with this time I'll take a secbutyl magnesium bromide followed by hydrolysis. Now, you know, this is the substrate, and this part will be added up. So you join the secbutyl, hang onto the carbonyl carbon, and make double bond O as single bond OH. So for the first time, you can go via the mechanism route, arrow mark route. But from next time onwards, you need not have to go in that route. Straight way right. So this part, let us keep it as such. Don't make it straight or something. Don't change the skeleton. Remain as the same thing. So this will be O minus and followed by water. I don't have presence now. OH. And this part, secbutyl part, will remain attached to the carbonyl carbon. So this is a 3 degree alcohol. So always a 3 degree alcohol is produced when any grignard reagent, however substituted it may be, with a ketone, you get a 3 degree alcohol. How many of you have got it? Then we go to the next point. Till then, I'm interested to give you some more SAQs. This is a very important point. Tell me, this is the haloalkane chapter. Which we had revised. We will revise in the properties of alcohols. We will revise again, because we have not yet come to the properties. We are now doing research, doing PhD on in the preparation. A then magnesium ether, the preparation of Grignard reagent B, and then HCHO. That's it. Isopropyl alcohol with PBr3. Then magnesium ether to make a Grignard reagent, which we have already studied in our haloalkane chapter. And then formaldehyde, today's new thing, formaldehyde followed by hydrolysis. It's just, you know, you can do it in a flash. AK has raised his hand. Okay, this, let me tell you without wasting time. This will give you this one. A is OH will be removed by Br. It will be isopropyl bromide. And then this is A. B is isopropyl magnesium bromide. But magnesium will just be inserted in between carbon bromine bond. So you get the Grignard reagent. Then with formaldehyde and water, you know, whenever it is formaldehyde, then you just attach a CH2OH group to the group R. So this R, which is isopropyl, is joined by a hydroxymethyl group. This becomes CH2OH. So once again, we got isobutyl alcohol. Now, if you are not sure, then you go via the mechanism route I explained to you. You expand HC double bond OH, and then in the way we discussed this, you join MgBr with O minus MgBr plus, then add water, then make it. So you can do that. Until you are confident that yes, I need not have to open this and then add nucleophilic addition. So this formaldehyde will be converted to CH2OH, and 1 degree alcohol is obtained, right? So all the rest, please. Watch and write very carefully. Otherwise, there will be no gain. It will be all loss. It is better to just sleep. Come in the morning time. Sleeping is very peaceful, calm, very pleasurable. So you enjoy your sleep rather than. Now, let us go to the next point. This point number, I don't know. Can you tell me what is the point number? SS, what's the point number?
Six.
These two numbers you have already done. Just a revision. Hydroboration, oxidation. We will revise, no worries. Because this is an alkene. In alkene, many newcomers were not there at that time. Particularly Priyanka, Priyadarshini, and a few. Hydroboration, oxidation. You produces anti-Markovnikov alcohol. Produces. The addition is not anti-Markovnikov. The first step, you know, if you take an unsymmetrical alkene and treat it with diborane, so that becomes only borane CH3 tetrahydrofuran medium, it will become a monomer, not B2H6. If you write B2H6, no harm, you can write that. But BH3THF followed by oxidation with hydrogen peroxide, alkaline hydrogen peroxide, you know. That, as if Priyanka, you are adding water. As if you are adding water in an anti-Markovnikov way. Supposing OH is minus delta, H is plus delta. So the negative part will be attached to the carbon bearing more number of hydrogen atoms. So it is anti-Markovnikov addition. So the ultimate product will be RCH2CH2OH. But actually there is no addition of water. This is just your analysis to write down the product in one go. It is not really hydration reaction. It is in two steps. One is the formation of trialkyl borane. Addition is Markovnikov. The actual addition process is Markovnikov in the first step, as you remember. And in second step, when oxidation occurs to the trialkyl borane, and finally alcohol you see, you find it is looking like an anti-Markovnikov alcohol, as if water has been added in an anti-Markovnikov style. And you know the salient points. You can tell me. The salient points is formation of trialkyl borane in the first step. That is R CH2CH2 whole 3B. That is by a cyclic transition state. And in the second step, oxidation of the trialkyl borane. This is by Markovnikov addition, the first step. In the first step by Markovnikov's way or method, oxidation of trialkyl borane by H2O2 OH minus to form an alcohol, which looks like an anti-Markovnikov alcohol, and no rearrangement. That is the beauty. No rearrangement product, because it doesn't go via carbocation. So no rearrangement product. And in the last case, the stereospecificity of reaction is seen addition of H and OH. That is the highest jankari aapke liye. So over. We are revising this because that also comes in the alcohol chapter. Say this one, three molecules of this will react with one molecule of borane, monoborane in THF to form RCH2CH2 whole 3B. You know, this H will be joining here, BS2 will be joining here. In three successive steps. So this H is the negative part and BS2 is the positive part. So this addition is Markovnikov. Boron is more electropositive, or hydrogen is more electronegative than boron. So hydrogen is carrying the fractional negative charge. So the addition is Markovnikov. And then when you oxidize by hydrogen peroxide, these three bonds will independently break to produce three molecules of anti-Markovnikov of alcohol plus BOH whole 3, this is nothing but orthoboric acid. Miss AT, you have a question. Very good. Yes. So she has allowed me to gulp. I mean, not to gulp.
Good morning, sir. Good
morning. Please carry on.
The RCH.
R? Oh, I'm so sorry. Thank you. I thought you should prolong your question so that I complete my quota of adrak, I mean ginger tea. You have a small suggestion to make that I have made a mistake here, RCHCH2. Okay, good. I like it. So this is an anti-Markovnikov alcohol, as if water has been added, you know, Priyanka, that OH has been added, so as if you have added water. Don't write this. As if you have added water to alkene in an anti-Markovnikov way. OH has gone to this carbon, H has gone to this carbon. So this is as if. But actually, there is no as if. So this, supposing I'll give you a problem, SAQ on this. And such a question will definitely make me complete my ginger tea. Yes, oh, sorry. Now, so many hands have been raised. Try to tally your answer with mine very, very meticulously. Now, this is nothing but an anti-Markovnikov addition of water, hydroboration oxidation to give you isobutyl alcohol. Of course, in two steps, but we regard as if it is addition of water. And then thionyl chloride or PCl5 will produce the corresponding. Who can tell me there is a chiral center? I would like to ask you. Now, this constant revision is required. In thionyl chloride, if there is a chiral center, what will happen to the stereochemistry, the configuration of the product vis-a-vis the configuration of the reactant? Raise your hands. Here there is no chiral center. So such a situation will not arise here. But in those cases, say secondary alcohol, whereas there is a hydrogen atom and other two groups along with OH, you are treating with thionyl chloride alone. Yes, Arpita, you'd like to answer? I want to see more aggression in your learning and in your preparation. Yes, sir. Arpita.
Yes, sir.
Please.
Sir, isopropyl chloride?
No. I'm not asking that question. I'm asking what will happen to the stereochemistry when thionyl chloride is used with a alcohol having a chiral center. Who will answer this question? Okay. Adi. Adi, who appears to come at par with Susovan. Let's see today.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
So it will be retention of configuration.
Precisely, it will be retention of configuration. Now tell me another question. Same Adi. Supposing I will add pyridine. I mean, the solvent used is pyridine. Then what will happen?
So inversion of configuration.
Precisely, inversion
it will follow SN2 reaction.
Precisely, both the answers are correct. Now make sure when you are looking at a problem, whether pyridine is written or not. If thionyl chloride with pyridine is there, then like PCl3, like PCl5, there will be inversion of configuration. But if no pyridine, then it is retention. That question will arise when there is a chiral center. Here there is no such question. Then the next one, you just check, mute yourself, Adi. And then this will be the corresponding magnesium chloride. Preparation of Grignard reagent. Magnesium will be inserted here. And then we know that when any Grignard reagent is added to any ketone, it will be a 3-degree alcohol. The entire isobutyl will be hanging onto this, and this will be converted to an alcoholic group. So you can do the same skeleton. This becomes OH, and this isobutyl will be hanging down. Don't change it. Remain as the same, the way you have you have written the ketone or aldehyde. You keep it like that. Hang the alkyl group from the Grignard reagent down the carbonyl carbon. Make it a sp3 alcohol. So how many of you have done this answer correctly? Every time you converse yourself with writing the names, IUPAC names, then only you will be very confident in writing IUPAC names. And if possible, if it's a smaller one, it has got a nickname. Tert butyl alcohol, sec butyl alcohol, and so on. Okay. Then we leave a bit of space. I am losing a bit of patience today. Another 3 to 4 methods of preparation are there, which we'll be resuming tomorrow. But let's today enter into properties. Because alcohol property, I'm so excited to discuss with my students, because alcohol is having a burning test. How do you know? If you have not tested, how do you know that it is having a burning test? Then you will say, it is in the book. I have learned from the book, or my teacher has told that it has a burning test. It's not necessary that I would have to test alcohol to say what is the test of alcohol. No, it is having a burning test, and it is an alcoholic beverage recommended by doctors to take for healthy body and mind. Both body and mind are controlled by taking a requisite dose of alcohol. That dose may be 3 pegs, 4 pegs, 5 pegs, depending on the situation. Properties of alcohols, leave about 2 pages. Liberally leave about 2 pages. Right? Then properties. I will feel little more relaxed that we have entered into properties. Although you know more than me, you know the teacher's nature more than hopefully I know my nature, that this teacher will not leave anything untold. That is the irony of our fates. that we should not have been loaded with so much of information for which we don't deserve. I'm sorry, I'm not addressing to all. Maybe all, until and unless you prove otherwise. Ask me some good questions every time to make me provoked, make me encouraged. And not only that, but also show your worth in examination in organic. We can do that. You have the parts, but you are not sure about yourself. That is the whole problem. Now, what I was saying is properties. First, we shall take up not the physical properties. Once I enter into physical properties, you know, I will be excited. And I will not retreat from that. So chemical properties, first we shall take up. But physical properties are very important. Not only how it tests, how it keeps our body and mind good, but also others like boiling point, solubility, and many other aspects we shall be discussing. Chemical point, first point is acidic property. I just revise your alcohols are usually, excepting methanol, less acidic than water. But more acidic than alkyne. You know the position of alcohol vis-a-vis the alkynes and water. And you remember its pKa is as high as about 16, in the vicinity of 16, is little higher, slightly higher than water. More is the pKa, less is the acid strength. Slightly, but methanol has a little lower pKa than water, excepting methanol. We had a discussion, someone asked me why methanol is having slightly more acidic than water. So I also interacted to that at those times, but you were not revising those things again and again. Now, what I was saying, water in general, more acidic than alcohol, then it continues. And phenol is stronger. We are not talking about phenol. We will be discussing that later on. And then carboxylic acids. And then any other strong acids. Now, carboxylic acids are weak acids. These are all weak. And HF is also weak. Many weak acids from the inorganic domain also fall here. Then I'm talking of HX. Not HF. HF is also stronger than many carboxylic acids. pKa is about 4, 3.76, but this is about 4.76 acetic acid, and still greater if R group will be bulkier, but it should be lesser if there is a minus I group like chloro, bromo, nitro. So that all depends. So I'm taking up HX, HCl, HBr, HI, strong, then carboxylic acid, then phenol, water, alcohol. So alcohol acidity is not high enough to be exhibited. You know, it does not write down, does not respond to litmus test. Alcohol is not that much acidic which responds to litmus paper. It doesn't turn blue litmus red, but it doesn't mean that it is not acidic. It is acidic. Water is acidic. So water also doesn't change the color of litmus. Carboxylic acid does, phenol does change the color of blue litmus to red. They are, you know, sizably, I mean, appreciably acidic to the extent of the H plus ion concentration is good enough to make a change in the color of litmus, blue litmus. But not these ones. These ones, they do not change the color of litmus. But acidic. So what happens? Strong and active metals like sodium, lithium, sodium, potassium, etc. And strong bases like sodium hydride or lithium hydride. Here the hydride ion is the base, not sodium ion. Here lithium, sodium, potassium metal is the base. And here hydride ion is the base, displaces hydrogen from alcohol. Although we do not get a litmus property, but the acidic property is very much observed when we put a active metal like sodium, potassium or lithium on an alcohol, you get strong effervescence. So for example, ROH treated with sodium or lithium, you get effervescence, form alkoxide salt and hydrogen gas. This is sodium alkoxide. This is a salt, the salt of alcohol. Alcohol is an acid. Water is also acid. And interestingly, they are amphoteric. Just after some time, we'll discuss that like water, alcohol is also amphoteric. It has basic property too. Acidic as well as basic like water. The acidic property is exhibited when we treat it with a strong metal, but not to the extent that any alkali, no reaction. It is not acidic to the extent that it will react with an alkali to form water and salt. That happens with phenol, with carboxylic acid. You can justify that using your Bronsted-Lowry concept. If you write the ionic equation like this, then you cannot say alcohol being a weaker acid than water. A weaker acid cannot displace a stronger acid, or a weaker base cannot displace a stronger base. So your knowledge, ready-made knowledge about the basic acid-base theory is required. So I urge upon you to either see the video we had once again on the Bronsted theory and how to find the equilibrium constant for an acid-base reaction by dividing with the K value of left minus K value of right. The left acid by right acid. We had an extensive discussion in our program. So you have to have a ready-made knowledge about the Bronsted theory now, because we are dealing with alcohol, phenol, which are acidic. Alcohol is less acidic than phenol. We also have to know, revise our general organic chemistry. I shall be asking you why alcohol is less acidic than phenol, or conversely, why phenol is more acidic than alcohol. We shall all be discussing. So for organic, you have to revise again and again, particularly the GOC, the isomerism and nomenclature, and the previous things, which are all interdependent. Now, say we take an alcohol, we do not have sodium, potassium or lithium, you can add hydride. They say sodium hydride or lithium hydride. That also will produce, you know, this hydride ion will displace hydrogen ion in the form of hydrogen. This bond will heterolytically cleave to produce alkoxide ion. And H minus will displace hydrogen and combine with H plus ion to produce the neutral, hydrogen gas. So don't be surprised if you are given an hydride instead of a metal, sodium, lithium, you are getting a hydride, which will do the same thing, but not hydroxide. Hydride is not the same. Hydride is a very, very strong base although a very poor nucleophile. Nucleophilicity is very poor. It's very hard, being very small size. So it doesn't like to give away its lone pair and attack onto a electrophilic center. But it has a high capacity to abstract a proton and shows its utmost basicity, not nucleophilicity. So, and I'll ask you relative acid strength. I'll ask you a question. I am not in a hurry because these are important chapters. So why 1 degree alcohol is more acidic than 2 degree alcohol? You have to answer this. We have all discussed in our GOC program. And 3 degree is least acidic. Why? How can you explain? You can explain in two ways. One, plus I effect. More the plus I effect. You know, this is a small group. The plus I effect is small. There are two R dash, so the net plus I effect is more. And the net plus I effect is maximum in 3 degree alcohol. So you know, more is the plus I effect, less is the acid strength. That is the general principle applicable for either carboxylic acids or alcohols. But you can also explain in another way by using steric effect. More is the substitution, more is the bulk, more is the degree of alcohol. 1 degree, this is 2 degree, is 3 degree. Now the conjugate base of the alcohol, the alkoxide ion, is less hydrated and less stabilized due to steric hindrance. Due to steric hindrance, the alkoxide ion produced by 3 degree alcohol is less hydrolyzed. I mean, it's less hydrated and hence less stabilized due to steric inhibition of solvation, SIS, for which if the conjugate base is less stable, the corresponding alcohol is less acidic. So let me write down this explanation, which sounds better than the plus I effect, which I didn't tell you in at that time. Therefore, I'm writing the conjugate base alkoxide ion RO minus is less hydrated and stabilized, and hence less stabilized in the above order due to steric, let us, we use a hi-fi term, steric inhibition of solvation, hydration, or in general solvation. Simply you can write due to steric hindrance. If you cannot remember this hi-fi term, steric inhibition of solvation, you just write due to steric hindrance. The alkoxide ion is less hydrated. Less is the extent of hydration, less is its stability. And less is the stability of the alkoxide ion, that is its conjugate base, less is the strength of the corresponding alcohol as an acid. I have written in a very short and brief manner, which you are supposed to write in examination. If you are asked a question, why tert butyl alcohol or tert butanol, in a very crude way, tert butanol is a weaker acid, than a specific question I'm asking, than say isobutyl alcohol or N-butyl alcohol or even sec butyl alcohol. The answer is the tert butoxide ion is bulky and has greater steric crowding. That steric hindrance is more for the solvation, for the hydration. So the alkoxide ion produced from that is less stable in aqueous solution. Therefore, the corresponding alcohol, tert butyl alcohol, is less acidic. The same explanation. Then we take up one more thing. Supposing I will ask you a question, say, tell me which is more acidic. Say, tell me, what should I write? So far as the alkyl group is concerned, we can ignore the plus I effect. Just consider the steric effect and can answer more elegantly, more convincingly than bringing in plus I effect. But when there is a minus I group, you know, minus I effect enhances the acid strength. You know what happens in carboxylic acid, same thing happens here in alcohol. The same principle applies. So this is a much stronger acid than ethanol, our favorite alcohol. This is trichloroethanol, beta, 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 or 2,2,2 trichloroethanol is much more acidic than ethanol because of strong minus I effect. Here, it is better. Why better? Is the only way to explain by minus I effect. But in case of the increase in the degree of substitution from 1 degree alcohol to 2 degree alcohol to 3 degree alcohol, it is better to explain in terms of steric effect. So with this, we take up another property. This is the acidic property of alcohol. We know that it doesn't react with alkali, NaOH, no. But active metal like sodium, potassium, yes. And hydride, metal hydride, yes. And the relative acid strength, we already have assessed how stronger, how weaker an alcohol might be vis-a-vis other alcohols or vis-a-vis carboxylic acids and phenols that we have also analyzed. Then we take up another last point, that is its reaction to, its reaction with HX, hydrohalic acid, HCl, not HF, HBr, HI. This is a substitution reaction. And for 3 degree alcohol, and of course, to a large extent in 2 degree and 1 degree, all except ethanol and methanol. This is by SN1 mechanism because there is a carbocation formation. Other than except methanol and ethanol. And for that, you have to have SN2. Because the primary carbocation is not stable. But you might be asking, thinking, Adi, that what about N-propyl alcohol? You know, N-propyl carbocation is unstable, but there is a room for hydride ion migration to produce a relatively more stable 2-degree carbocation. So they have a chance to go via SN1 mechanism, but there can be some percentage of SN2 from primary alcohol. Say, for example, over we go to specifics. Say, for example, we have an alcohol, CH3, we take a tertiary alcohol. And we can make a chiral center too. And we add HCl. There is no room. It will be substitution. And you get a turbidity. And mind you that this reaction is slow unless you take the help of a catalyst, a Lewis acid catalyst, that is zinc ion. zinc chloride is usually taken as a catalyst for adding HCl. But HBr and HI, they do not require any catalyst. Because their nucleophilicity is greater, because their soft bases, as you go down the group, nucleophilicity and basicity, they go anti-parallel, as you know. You have just now appeared the test. So you get water. This is definitely via SN1 mechanism. Because third butyl carbocation is very, very stable, so it has to go via SN1. But in a broader sense, if you write down the mechanism, have you written this? If you write down the mechanism, supposing it's a 3D alcohol or any alcohol, first it will be protonated. The first step is the protonated, because HX not only is a provider of nucleophile X minus, but also is a provider of H plus. So the first step, the alcohol will be protonated. So it will generate a very good living group, water. You know that OH minus ion is a very, very poor living group, being a strong base. So when it is protonated, the living group is no longer OH minus. It is water. When a nucleophile X minus now will attack, either in the same step, that is SN2 or SN2 or SN1, whatever, depending on whether it is a primary alcohol and that to ethyl methyl, and to some extent propyl and any other 1 degree. And in others, it is SN1. So whatever the case may be, so this is RX plus water. The living group is no longer OH minus ion. It is neutral water, which is a weak base, is a good living group. So protonation enhances its livability or fugicity, and you go via either SN1, most of the time it is SN1 or SN2. But HCl, ZnCl2, remember this, 3 degree alcohol, SN1, but 1 degree and 2 degree, the mechanism is slightly different. It is general mechanism, no ZnCl2, HBr and HI. 1 degree alcohol, it is SN2. I will tell you the role of zinc ion. What is the role of zinc ion? Because chloride ion is not the best nucleophile, like bromide and iodide being a softer and bulkier basis, being more nucleophilic. But chloride ion is not that much nucleophilic. So what happens when we take a alcohol with zinc chloride, say ZnCl2, and since ZnCl2 is a Lewis acid, it accepts a lone pair, and that produces same thing. This is metal. So this is the donor, this is the acceptor. Zinc will carry a formal negative charge, oxygen plus charge, same thing. This is hydration, this is protonation. Alcohol is same as the addition with zinc chloride, but you know, the electrophilicity, because of the plus charge, the electrophilicity becomes so high because of the metallic character of zinc that chloride ion attacks in the second step. for 1 degree, 2 degree in a one step SN2 way, and if it is 3 degree, then there is no way out. First, it will break down to form a 3 degree carbocation, and then chloride ion will attack. So RCl plus, then OH, you know, Cl2, the OH will be joined, and zinc will be carrying as usual the negative charge, and this OH will be there, and then what happens, since you have acid, so this bond ultimately breaks to produce water, and ZnCl2 is set free to act as a catalyst. So the role of zinc ion, I could have taken only zinc, Zn2+. In that case, situation would have been little more intriguing. So instead of minus charge, it will be plus one. Plus two is converted to plus one. One charge will be decreased. So I didn't do that. I took it as a neutral molecule. And by that, showing plus minus, the formal charge in a dirty bond becomes simpler to understand. Right? So what I was saying, this is used as a distinction between 1 degree and 2 degree and 3 degree alcohols, Lucas test. This is the end of our program, today's program. 1 degree alcohol, sorry, first let us say 3 degree alcohol with HCl and zinc chloride gives immediate turbidity. Why turbidity in 1 minute? Reaction is very fast. It goes via SN1 mechanism in 1 minute, very fast at room temperature. And the product is a 3 degree chloride. Same SN1 mechanism. But if it is 2 degree, you know, then it reacts slower. It reacts slower. It goes via SN2. Unless it attacks in one step, it doesn't go. You might be wondering why not secondary carbocation is formed. Because the bond is so strong with metal that it cannot go first. Just like, you know, in 3 degree, protonated 2 degree alcohol, water goes to form a moderately stable secondary carbocation, or if there is a room for hydride transfer, there can be a promotion from 2 degree to 3 degree, or even 1 degree. That is possible only in presence of acid, not zinc chloride. If it is zinc chloride, the bond becomes so strong that unless the attack is made by the nucleophile, the bond will not break. Only for 3 degree alcohol, the stability factor is so dominating that the bond breaks to form a very strong, highly stable 3 degree carbocation. Now in this case, a slow reaction, a zinc chloride must be there, and it forms 2 degree chloride, but slowly white turbidity appears in 5 minutes. You have to wait. You have to sec, not raise the temperature. Room temperature you get, but it is slow. You have to consume some energy to sec the test tube for a long time. Not as easy for 3 degree alcohol, which goes via SN1 readily. This is via SN2. And finally, 1 degree alcohol doesn't give any white turbidity. So slow. This is also SN2, it gives, but no turbidity at room temperature. Why turbidity? Only on boiling. See the vigorous condition. The bond doesn't break. There is no, you know, driving force for the, because it has to go via SN2, but the bond breaking requires you know, since always the bond breaking is supported by the carbocationic character. I am not saying carbocation is formed. Carbocationic character of that particular species, and not a carbocation, true carbocation is formed, but the transition state has a carbocationic character. So that, since it is not stable, therefore the reaction is very slow. But in case of 2 degree, there is a greater plus delta, not plus, plus delta, for, which is more stabilized. And therefore, the breaking is possible even at room temperature. But 3 degree, readily, because it forms, it reacts with SN1 mechanism. So no SN2, but these two SN2, but the carbocationic character is least here. So the bond breaking takes place very slow. And at room temperature, it doesn't budge an inch. So only by boiling the solution, so the reaction happens, the extra activation energy is acquired, and you get white turbidity on boiling. Boys and girls, sorry for the delay. Thank you for your patient hearing. We will continue from here next time. This is the way how we distinguish between the three types of alcohols. When you take a 3 degree alcohol, add HCl in presence of zinc chloride, immediately you get white turbidity. And that is a 3 degree chloride. And this is a 2 degree chloride, RCHRCl. And this is a 1 degree chloride, which is not formed at room temperature, but it is formed only on boiling. So this is a 3 degree chloride, which is readily formed. This is a 2 degree chloride, which is formed after a bit of delay, maybe 5 minutes. And this does not form at room temperature. Only on boiling it forms RCH2Cl, 1 degree halide. Bye-bye.